to introduce?
Hi, I'm Alex Meyers, and I am doing our weekly hive inspection of the Westbank Community Garden beehive. So we've already taken the top off. We are about to take off the inner cover. We've already smoked our bees to calm them down and let them know we're here. So I'm using my hive tool, and I am gently prying the top off because the bees have been making propolis, which is a very sticky substance which keeps out intruders like ants and other bees and raccoons and such. But we need to get in there, so we want to do it very gently. Sam, can you? No, you can't be here. Hold on. Sam, come here. Sam, you need to stay behind the fence. Taking a commercial break. Okay. All right, so we are, and we're doing this gently because we don't want to make a big cracking sound because bees don't like loud noises.
There they are.
Okay.
Woo. So how many bees do we have about?
So we started with about 10,000 about 6 weeks ago.
10,000 6 weeks ago.
And we should be getting up, we might have 20 or 30,000 now. So
wow.
every day the queen lays, I forget the exact number, but at least 1,000 eggs. Of course, every day some bees die, and it takes about 21 days for an egg to turn into a fully grown adult, so we're still in the building up. 40,000 is about an established mature hive.
Okay.
But we're still in the baby stages.
Okay.
So we've got 10 frames inside our hive. This is a frame holder. We're gonna put that here, and we're gonna, as we're looking at each frame, we're gonna put one frame here to just make space so we can look.
Okay.
And the main things we're looking for right now is we wanna see evidence of the queen laying eggs, which means looking for those teeny tiny little eggs, making sure that there aren't any signs of disease, like mites all over the place or something really wrong. We wanna see, in a perfect world, we want to actually see the queen, which is bigger and longer than the other bees, and she came marked with a little white, her bottom is painted white.
Oh.
But as the hive grows, it gets harder and harder to see her because she's just
amongst everybody else.
She's amongst everybody else. So I saw her for the first couple inspections, and I didn't see her for the others, but I saw eggs. So I know she's doing okay. At least she was doing okay a few days prior.
Look at that.
So, you know, I'm just going to give another little, every few minutes you want to give a little bit of smoke.
And what does that do again?
That calms the bees down in a few different ways. It covers the alarm pheromone that our guard bees are giving off. And it also makes them think that the hive might be on fire, like a forest fire,
mm-hmm.
and that prompts them to go down to their honey stores and stuff themselves
because
they might need to go and find a new home. So hopefully all that will distract them from the fact that there's a weird thing in white looking at their hive. And we wear white because bees don't like dark colors, because we look like bears when we are wearing brown or black. They think we're bears. So that's why we wear white. So we look at each frame because we are a new hive and bees work from the inside out. There's not much going on the outside hives. So this, we're not seeing honeycomb or brood. Brood is the name for the young, the eggs and the larvae and the pupa and stuff. So there's not much to see here. You can see a little bit, if you see that kind of sparkling white stuff in there, that's probably nectar that they've been collecting. Or it could be water that they've been collecting. but it's hard to tell with these outside frames. When we get inside, we'll be able to see a little bit more. Using my hive tool again to separate the frames, because the propolis has been, they kind of use it as duct tape. And you don't want to keep a hive open for more than about 20 minutes. It kind of disturbs their routine. It doesn't upset them, but it just kind of... Okay, so this one is much heavier, at least twice as heavy.
Wow. Yeah, you can definitely tell.
So, you can see here some of the different comb patterns. You can see them gathering or creating honey. The white capped, let's see, I believe that is honey that has been capped or covered. The different colors, as we get inside, the different colored caps will show you what it is. So when we get inside, that's where the eggs are being laid. The color will be less white and more tan or brown. So, I'm looking for the queen, but not freaking out if I don't see her. I'm gently flipping it over. You always want to look at both sides. And throughout the year, as the bees feast on pollen from different plants, you will see different color nectar. You know, blue, pink, yellow, orange. I haven't seen that yet because we're new and they're mostly eating the supplemental feed that we're giving them. But I'm looking forward to when that happens. So I'm using my hive tool again. You know what? Give them a little more squirt. Girls will be out of your hair soon. And as you can see, I'm not wearing gloves. Every beekeeper has their own level of comfort, and it also depends a lot on the weather and how old your hive is and at what stage it's at. If we were doing this, if we were gathering honey right now, I'd probably be wearing gloves. If this were a hive that was completely full, I'd be wearing, anyway, long story short, I'm not wearing gloves because it will make me more clumsy and more apt to kill bees. So this one's a nice example. You see the darker capped areas, kind of a dark yellow. Under there is brood. Those are baby bees being incubated, isn't the right word, growing in there. And you can see, let's see, you can see some of them that haven't been capped yet. If you zoom in there, they look like kind of little maggots, little round, you know what, not maggots, grubs. They look like grubs. So the ones that were just laid a day or two ago will look like the tiniest, like a little black bug on that. That may have been a beetle that, yeah, okay. And that's a good thing we need to note. This beetle here is a common,
is it a pest?
Yes. And one or two does not show a problem, but that's one of the things that you check during an inspection is how many non-bee friends do we see in there. So I'm really liking seeing all of these grub-like baby bees. And as we maybe go to the next one and the next one in, I hope to see eggs that were just laid in the last day or two, which will look like the tiniest. Okay, I know.
Well, thanks for showing us.
Anyway, so that's the general idea. Thanks for coming along. And if you want to come along for a one-on-one in-person inspection with me, just let me know.
Thanks, Alex.
Thank you.